1918 on a Monday night, I boarded the train in Memphis to go to Nashville. Something was just telling me something's gonna happen.
The first thing I knew was this terrific impact, and the people were not only killed and dismembered and terribly mutilated, but to add to the tragedy, the wooden cars caught on fire.
When the trains run together, I tried to get out and I couldn't get out. I had to raise the window and the glass was all falling everywhere.
My father was called to the wreck. He had up there and he knew I was in it, but he, every time they pulled somebody out, he was looking to see if it was going to be me.
I never saw such a thing in my life. They were moaning and groaning. They were horse-drawn dead wagons all over the place, loaded with bodies, taking them out of there. It was something to never forget.
One sultry summer morning in the year of 1918, all aboard train number 4 pulled out of Union Station. Heading out of Nashville for Memphis, Tennessee, but the tickets they were holding held another destiny. That very moment on the Cheatham County line, number one train from Memphis was running way behind. Back in the smoky club car, Memphis gambling man said, "Gentlemen, I'm falling 'cause a true dead man's hand." A young man in a milk truck out near Dutchman's grave, sent my guy 2 trains, 1 track, then he closed his eyes and he prayed. A sister from the orphan's home made a cross upon her chest. The one iron beast was coming from the east and the other one was coming from the west. The birds flew from the treetops, the impact shook the ground. The treetops as the impact shook the ground. The screaming wheels and the grinding steel could be heard for miles around.
Now every July 9th, a few miles west of town, to this day some folks say you can hear that mournful sound.